my friends, how are you doing? Well, today a total different phone. Today I'm here with the HTC HD2. It runs Windows Phone 7 operating system. I can show that real fast to you. Let's start it up so you can have an idea of what this is. It's a HTC. And it runs, I think, not the official ROM, Windows ROM of this phone. Because in fact this thing, it looks like Windows 8.1, but it's Windows Phone 7. So here you can see it, Windows Phone. It's booting up. And we're gonna install Android on this thing. You see that? A developer even ported Android 7.1 to this device, but it's very low on memory. So we're not gonna do that. This device is from 2009. It's more than 8 years old. So it's very old phone. 9 years, I think it is. And in fact, yeah, this is it. You see that? It looks just like a Windows phone. It's not Windows Mobile with these, yeah. 6.5 look totally different. This looks just like Windows 8.1. So, but we're gonna kill the beats. We're gonna remove the battery. And the first thing that we will have to do, we'll have to download some files. These files are very important. We will need a custom bootloader. We will have to install Clockwork Mod, the custom recovery. And then we can go ahead and then flash a ROM onto this phone. So let's see how that must be done, and let's take a look at all the tools that must be downloaded. I must tell you, because of the age of this phone, it was a complete hassle to find files. Really, these files are on sites that changed into, you know, you can buy the domain, means whatever was there is gone and is, you know, not available anymore. But thanks to, you know, the internet, and thanks to the effort and the good of some guys out there, these files, you know, I could still get to them. And that's why we can still do this project today. So first of all, a big thumbs up to all you guys that are, you know, hosting these HTC HD2. ROMs, thumbs up for you. All the guys that are, you know, keeping these tools together, you must forgive me, but I'm gonna, you know, sip all the tools that you need to make a HD2, turn it into an Android phone. I'm gonna get all these files, you know, and this, if it will all go right, could fail, you know, I could break the thing, and then we should just forget about HTC HD2. But today I got one, and even though it's cracked, I already gave it a display protection, so it feels good whenever you touch it, so it's all good to me. We're gonna just see how far we will come and what we must do. But the first thing that we're gonna do is we're gonna put it in a bootloader state. We're gonna go into the bootloader of this phone, and to do that, you will have to hold the volume down and press the power. I keep pressing it until you see three blue screens. So let's do that. We're gonna hold the volume down and then press the power on and keep holding. And there we are. You see that? This is the screen that you want to get into. This is the boot loader screen. Now you're gonna need some tools. One of the tools that you will need is called Mac with a G. It's not Mac with a C, but Mac with a G. Mac Loader. I hear all sorts of new names today, so if I fail a little bit, don't worry, you know, as long as your name is not Adam Curry, everything's gonna come good. You're gonna get the file that I zipped, and whenever you unzip it, you're gonna find the Mac Loader. It's called bootloader effect, and it's a Mac bootloader 1 13DAF. You're gonna unpack it. Yeah, you know how to unpack a zip file, right? You guys are so smart. And girls that come to my site, you know what is Winra. With Winra, you can unpack a file. And when you unpacked it, you're gonna find a folder. And the folder is called Mac Loader 113DAF. You're gonna open it, and in there, you're gonna find ROM Update Utility. So go ahead and run it. Oh, wait, hold on. You're gonna run it as administrator if you're on Windows 7. And I understand here, next. I did these steps. It will say, did you put the phone into, did you connect to the USB? Establish active sync with the PDA, disable the standby and hibernation mode of the PC. Make sure the battery is more than 50%. I completed all these steps, so we go to the next. Verifying information of your PDA phone. Please wait. And now, you can see current information about your image version. Yeah, so we're just gonna hit update. Okay, to version, image version 2.0. We go next. Okay, can you all see it a little bit? Yeah, and next. So now updating the ROM image on your PDA phone. It was still called the PDA. Here you're gonna see the progress will start. You see that? Please do not remove. Remember, it will take about 10 minutes to do this all. So just leave it. Don't touch the cable, you know. Don't do crazy things. You see, congratulations. Your ROM update was completed. So now we say finish here. Okay. So now it's gonna go to, it wants to boot up again, I think. And we're gonna go to the next step. And the next step is that we're gonna flash. We're just gonna remove the battery. Okay, hold on. Let's see what's gonna happen. I think it wants to boot. 1, 2, 3, 4. And there we go. DFT, Dark Forest Steam. Okay, so what we're now gonna do, we remove the battery again. Okay, and we put it back, and we put in the power, and we're gonna press the power on, but keep holding the power until it goes into this mode. Keep holding, keep holding, keep holding, keep holding, and now you can let go. Now you're gonna say here, you're gonna go to USB flasher. You see that? Because now we're gonna install Clockwork Mod, and you're gonna confirm with this button here. So it's gonna say wait for USB. It's waiting to be flashed now. So wait again for the driver to be installed. Okay, we're gonna go to the recovery. There you're gonna find the DAF file again. This is effect the main program, the main software. Just run it after you. We went to the. You now open the Clockwork Mod and unpacked it, and in there you will find these tools here, these folders, this folder with these files in it, and just hit the DAF, the DAF 101, and then you're gonna hit next. Yes, please. I had to infect. It's waiting for the USB connection. This might take a second. Yes. In fact, I had to run this. There we go. You see that? Boom. Boom. Dang. Yes. Congratulations. Install is complete. And we can finish. Okay, so now we have it all installed. The bootloader, Clockwork Mod is installed, and now we must do some partitioning. Now we must make sure that the partitions are good and clean, so Android can be installed onto that. We're gonna also use a special version of Twerp that we can copy to the SD card, and so we can run it from out the recovery of this phone.
So let's go there. Let me show you what we're gonna do. Alrighty, we're gonna start up the phone and we're gonna keep holding the power button until we get into the recovery of this phone, the Mac loader. Okie doke. So as you can see, we have several possibilities in the Mac loader. There on top you can also see boot from SD. And what do you see? A little red saying that the kernel is not found. We're gonna fix that, because up there we're gonna install our twerp. But to get these files on the phone, we first gonna make a connection. So we're gonna go ahead and go to number 8, and there we're gonna find clockwork mod, the one that we just flashed, remember. We're gonna find it up there and we're gonna load it, and in some seconds it will pop up. There you go. Now we're gonna scroll down until it says mount, and we're gonna mount, go one tap up, that will be all the way down, and mount USB. Now that we mounted USB, we're gonna go to our computer. I can put the phone down and you can take a look at the computer. Oops, sorry for that. So what is the deal? We now gonna get the twerp that is meant for being unpacked to the SD card. I have it somewhere in my folder, so let's grab it. Let's unpack it with WinRAR. WinRAR is a tool that you must have installed on your computer. Every computer should have WinRAR, every Windows computer. So there you're gonna see the files, and we're just gonna put them on the SD card. Okay, let me first get them for you. There you can see that I have two versions, but I'm gonna go for the one that is meant for the SD card. We're gonna unpack it. It's in a folder. Unpack it and grab all these files and just put them on the SD card. Okay, because this will be our twerp, our temporary twerp that we're gonna use whenever we need it. We're gonna use it to partition the drives. Okie doke. So now that they are copied, we can in fact stop the connection again and go back to the phone. Okay, back in the phone, we're gonna hit unmount. Let me put the screen a little bit better so you have a total view. Okay, we're gonna go back, and now we're gonna say reboot the system. We're gonna hold down the power button again, so we go in the recovery of the phone again. Okay, so now we're gonna hit boot from SD, boot AD SD. What it's saying here, boot AD SD, means boot Android from SD, Android files. So we confirm here. You see there's no more red here, and then in a second we're gonna have twerp running on this device. Hocus pocus pass, and there is twerp. So what we now gonna do, we're gonna first go to advanced, and we're gonna say partition SD card. Okay, as you can see, size MB000, that is not good. Okay, we're gonna first increase this size to 1024. We can make it even bigger. Let's make it a little bit bigger, 2 gigabytes. And the size here, we're gonna make it 1024, and this one here will be 64. Okay, you see that? This X4, and this is fat. And then we're gonna partition. So now the complete phone is being wiped, the internal drives as well. Everything is being flashed. So now we're gonna trick the system in a second. When this is done, we're gonna trick it, and I'm gonna show you how to do that. It's partitioning the SD card,
removing current partition table, creating first partition, blah blah, SD card 1, formatting def, blah blah blah, FAT, creating second partition, partition SDXT. And this can only be done after you, of course, fixed the bootloader and you installed all these, the Mac loader and the clockwork mod that also comes with a DA file, a DAF file that you will have to run. And in the Mac loader you also have a part. Whenever you open it, I'm gonna show that it's partitioning now, so we don't have to really look at that. I can show you about the Mac loader. This is in fact the first app that you're gonna run if you're gonna do this. And up here you also see ROM update utility. Okay, instead of the DAF, when you run the DAF and it says no bootloader found, blah blah blah, then you're gonna run the ROM update utility, and then you're gonna put the phone into the bootloader three color mode, yeah, with the volume down and the power. You turn it on, you keep holding, and then you're gonna get in such a mode showing the blue and the red, you know, and then you wait for USB to connect. And then, in fact, you run the ROM update utility. In fact, it will show in the software what you should do, in what state you should put the phone. But just to understand this phone, if you're gonna start the phone and you keep holding the home button, you will get into the Mac loader, okay, the Mac loader screen, the kind of recovery that you found in here. That in fact also has a possibility to start up Windows in there. So we can go in there and just select Windows. But I formatted everything. The phone is now, I in fact made the Android phone of it. You know, there's no more Windows on here. But Windows could of course be installed again. But hey, don't talk about Windows, okay? Windows is dead. Windows phone is 100% dead. There is a market in there that will never connect. You will not be able to install one app. You will only look at the tiles that are there in front of you that looks like iPhone. What is it? Phone 8? WP Phone 8? Windows Phone 8? Or even 10? But that's all you will be able to do. There's no app store in there. The market was not connecting for me. I could not see any connection, so I could not download anything. Okay, now we cleaned the drive. So listen, now we need to trick the device. What we're gonna do, we're gonna go back home and we're gonna say mount, yeah, and we say mount USB storage, and we're gonna wait, we're gonna put it on its side like that, very soft and slowly, and we're gonna wait for that to pop up. You see that there, we got a pop-up telling us, hey, boom boom boom. But now you can see the twerp is gone, so we're gonna put the twerp back because it doesn't know yet that the twerp is not on the SD card. So we kind of tricked it. It's still running twerp, and when we're gonna get out of the mount, it will look for its files and it cannot find it, and it will not go good, you understand? And here I have the iPair. This is the V2. We're gonna copy that to the drive, my friends. 238 megabytes. I made a very nice big space for the Android to be installed. Okay. So we should have enough space to put it on the NAND drive. But we can use the NAND and the SD card. I think we're gonna install it that way. Okay, So now I only hope that my V2 will work. V1 is lighter, has a firewall, has the things that you just saw. And this has a little bit more. This also has my scanner radio built in, my NPO. I must tell you that for my Dutch people, NPO is not working. Eh? It's working, but only radio. You will not be able to play video. Like video on here from NPO. So we're gonna unmount. We wait, you see, it knows that everything is still there. So we're gonna go home. We're gonna kick out the battery. Kick out the battery like this. And then we're gonna go back into the recovery of the phone. We're gonna go into clockwork mode recovery. And that is number 8. Yeah. We confirm with the hang up button. This will give us clockwork mode recovery. And we're gonna go to backup and storage. No. We're gonna go to mount and storage. And we're gonna format boot, format cache, format data. Format system, so, and in fact we already formatted the SD card, so we don't have to do that anymore. So we're gonna go to, we can also do the installer from here, we don't need twerp. Up here we can say IPA PUCROM, yes, install it. And when it goes to the aroma, we should have now more space on the NAND drive. There you go. Free 319 megabytes. You see that here? So now we're gonna hit next. So this is good. We're gonna say here NAND and data. So it's gonna use the NAND drive and the external card. Okay. We can just say full install. I'm not gonna disable the hotkeys because they are kinda handy. So there we go. This is it. So, my friends. And this installer is not so fast, huh? It's a little bit slow, okay? Here you can see that the Mac loader the bootloader is found. Setting permissions, siblings, and the installation went fine. I'm so proud of myself and of course of the developer that created this ROM way back in 2013. He out of nothing, he's gonna get a whole lot of attention again, and gladly I could get this ROM. It was not easy, my friends, because these ROMs, they were all before posted at the DH developers host dev host website, and that site is a terrible site. Eh? It became a terrible site. I think that all developers up there should remove all their files if they can still get onto the website. If they can still log in, they should remove all their files and put it on Mediafire or Mega Upload, you know? These are better sites. These are reliable sites. The others are not reliable. I have my Mediafire for so many years. It never went down on me. Although I must say that Mediafire is also letting advertisers such as these guys that are claiming that your Mac has a virus and all these, you know, I think these companies should be forbidden because they are a scam. But then again, it seems to be all allowed these days. There we are. 3, 2, 1. Almost go. Almost. My timing was almost good. And there we are, ladies and gentlemen. United States. We're gonna skip that. We don't have no SIM card. Up here I had a problem with my other ROM. I could not get into any Wi-Fi station. Don't skip. Finish. And then boom, beeps. Look at that. Just like how you want to see it. Okay. Boom. Look at that. The first thing that you're going to do, you're going to go to the little apple here, the preferences. And you're going to say RAWs and page. You're going to set that to 4. Okay. Otherwise, it will look like ugly. And there you go. We are installed. And how much space do we have? Let me show that to you. Where was that again? Storage, yeah? Where is storage? Here. Up here we have 2 more gigabytes available in apps. And we have about 26 gigabytes free space on the SD card, as you can see. It's kind of nice. So I could, I'm thinking of making the internal storage. I want to make it like some gigabytes. I want to make it bigger. So whenever you're gonna install apps, the thing won't start complaining about it's full. So I'm gonna partition that drive even bigger. Oops, I'm getting a message there. Okay. Getting lots of messages there on WhatsApp. But I cannot answer because we're making a video. One more thing that you must do. I'm gonna show that real fast. You see all the apps are installed. The firewall, if you're gonna tap it, it will ask for permission, root permission. Up here just say remember the choice forever and allow. Okie doke. And up here you can then go ahead and turn it on. And set the whitelist to blacklist. And then you can start blocking apps. Boom, boom. And then dun dun. What more can we block? Control center we're gonna block. The gallery we can block. Keyboard we should block. Google Play Store we're not gonna use. Google Search not gonna use. iFiles is there. iNoti we're gonna block. iOS settings I'm gonna block. Market feedback agent I'm gonna block. Messaging I'm gonna block. The phone I will block. Root browser will be blocked. Microphone. Street view I'm not using that one. And home I'm gonna block. Okay. This is just fine. So here we're gonna say apply rules. Yeah. Gosh, man. Okay. There we are. Boom. You see that? So now the system is not even connected to the internet yet, but it's already blocking several apps. This device just became a great device, huh? Because it was really no good as a Windows device, really. No good at all. But now it's a good device. You see, we also have iNoti and it seems to work. Let me see if it really works. iNoti, let's turn it on. on. Yes. You can observe what you want, but you're gonna be not broadcasting that. Okay. Boom. So there we go. And now we have iNoti installed. You see that? And we have a nice control center that we must set up for a second. Let me show you how to do that. Make sure that you close the running apps as much as possible. The control center is one that is really maybe a little bit annoying in the beginning. Let me see where it is. I cannot even find it. It's there, but I don't see it. Where are you? Oh, there it is, man. I forget the icons that I give these things. Start. You go to touchable. Scroll down. Turn all these off. Okay. Set this to something like this here. You can leave it on 35. And this one you make a little, you put it in the middle like this. Yeah. And then you're done. You go home and you're gonna see that it's not there. To slide it up, just go like that. It won't bother anymore and pop up every time. Like this, you will not be able to slide it up. Other things will happen. Okay, that's because we did not turn off the soft keys. You will have to put your fingers above the home of the soft key to pull it up. But you will get used to it. Trust me. Just like this. You see? And iNoti is there. And I must say, congratulations, you guys got a beautiful, beautiful ROM for this phone, the HTC HD2, in the style of IPERPUC ROM. ROM was developed by, let's go to the settings. Oh, these are the settings, these are the the iOS settings, the quick settings, the pre-settings. Here you can see the Play Store. Yeah, I'm gonna turn that off in the apps, but you can just leave it. Here we have a boosting system that will boost our system and it will free memory for us. Very handy. Microsoft Launcher also has it. Yeah, what can I say more? Oh yeah, BB World, that is your app store. In fact, the app store that I use in my BlackBerry ROM. I just use it as the app store for here, but it's APK pure. Let there be no confusion, this is APK pure. About the ROM itself, this ROM was by a guy, a developer, that is now also in my family, and it's gonna get a lot of attention, is called Mr. Taitung. This is by Taitung, and Taitung created several ROMs, so I want to say thank you, Taitung. Thanks a million for this ROM. I really love the way it works. It's really stable. It's 4.3. It's not KitKat, but hey, it doesn't matter. It's just fine. So Taitung, yo, God bless. Okay, bro. And yeah, thanks a lot for making this ROM. Because thanks to you, this, what you see here now, can be shown in 2018. This is 5 years ago, I think it was, that this ROM was created. Let's take a quick look again at the work of Mr. Taitung. And it was created in 2013. Okay. So all credits for this, everything that you see, including the modding that I did, because that was all thanks to Taitung. Let there be no misunderstanding. This ROM was developed by Taitung, and all credits for this ROM goes to Taitung. I only updated it a bit and brought it back in the under the attention. I brought it back to you guys to, you know, play with it. And if you still have a device like this, you know, I got all the files also to for the Mac loader and the formatting and the repartitioning thing. All is in here in the description. I don't even know the link to the Taitung website anymore, but I will find it, and you will also find a link to his site, because it was a complete hassle with all these rums that I tested, that in fact all failed on me, and this was the only one that, you know, stood like a boss. So Taitung, for me, you are the king of the HD2. Thank you for your effort and your work. I hope you liked it. It was very long, but I'm sure you like it. Thanks again. Leave it a like if you did. Subscribe to my channel if you did not already. Hit the notifying bell so you'll be updated whenever I upload a new video again.